But I heard there was this controversial call during, I think, the fourth set when, I guess, Petrogas was slowly getting its groove on, and I think they could have owned, maybe, or won that set. But I know, Sinjin, you have a lot of thoughts on that because you thought that really messed them up, I guess, in some way, psychologically.
It was quite crucial because a lot of judgment call was involved on the side of our referees for that day. But in that particular moment, it's napaka-crucial kasi it was an overreach
Noreen
violation.
Noreen just kept nodding her head, right?
So I have a reply. I think Noreen has a better perspective being a former commissioner. She would have an idea like, was it actually was it called at the right time? Because some people are saying na parang, oh, pwedeng i-let go kasi at that moment, nagahabol naman to initiate a really good spirit of the game, etc.
Okay. To be honest, you cannot have a let go situation because the referees call it or make calls based on the plays that they see each play. And you know, if they make the wrong calls, they get grilled, diba? Si Yul Binosa is one of our top referees really in the country, at least for me. And he made the call as he saw it, which is the correct call. Yep. You can see it in the slow-mo. The ball hasn't crossed. And I think it was Nunag. She went over the net. So that was the correct call.
So do you think that kind of, I guess, a questionable call for some, you know, diminished the win for Creamline? Like, it didn't hype it up as much as other people expected.
It tarnishes the win, I guess, for Creamline. Of course, syempre, if you're on the side of Petrogas, you're gonna think, ay, niluto. Yeah. Bakit ganun naghahabol na yung Petrogas? But, syempre, yung calls na to, they're judgment calls and they're done at a particular moment when it actually happened. So, if it's a good call, it's a good call. So, you can't really just blame everything on the referee. It's also what's happening inside the court at that moment.